But this concept is very difficult to understand. How can a bashar benefit us? Because the proposition I gave you before was the proposition that we need our bashariyat, our manhood to exist. But the Prophet ﷺ does not need that. Why? Let me give you an example. Hadith in Bukhari and in Muslim. Bukhari and Muslim both have narrated this hadith. And there is only a variation of one word which I will tell you about. By the way, Imam Bukhari, everybody say Rahmatullah Alayh. Imam Bukhari was the follower of Hazrat Imam Shafi. He was a? He was a follower of Imam? So those people who believe in Bukhari should at least accept Imam Shafi. Or not? If they say that somebody who is muqallid is gumrah, is misguided, they say that anybody who is muqallid is gumrah, and yet they accept the hadiths presented by Imam Bukhari, who is also muqallid, just as a passing statement, as we say in Latin, obiter dicta. This is something just in passing. Anyway, some other time. Now, there's one hadith which is narrated by two separate narrators, one Hazrat Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and the other one by Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhum. They narrate the hadith that one day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reading namaz with jamaat, and when he finished his namaz, he turned around, he grabbed hold of one of the men and he said, "Ala tuhsin salatak?" You didn't read your namaz properly. Now tell me one thing, if you are Imam Sahib, he leads jamaat, after namaz, he grabs hold of you and he says, "You didn't read your namaz properly." What are you going to say, Imam Sahib? Were you looking at me or were you reading your own namaz? So, when you're reading your own namaz, you're looking at your own namaz. You're not supposed to be looking. There's a very famous joke in this respect about some members of the Tablighi Jamaat. They newly joined the Tablighi Jamaat. They said, "Oh, brothers, we should read namaz." So they came to the mosque, but they didn't tell him the full masla of namaz. So when he was standing in namaz, one of the boys, he accidentally let out with some wind. And he carried on. He carried on standing there. He didn't know the masla that when you break wind, you naturally go. So the person next to him, he started smelling this. He said, "This is serious problems here. We can't carry on with this namaz. This is terrible." So he did like this to him. In namaz, he did like this. This person thought, "What is he doing? He's just carried on reading his namaz." So then this person thought that this guy is still carrying on namaz. So he said, "Your namaz is broken. Go and do your wudu." So the person next to him, he said, "Oh, namaz mein nahi bolte. You don't speak in namaz." And the Imam Sahib was at the front, he said, "Sami Allah, liman amina shukra maini bolia." So you see, namaz is for Allah. Namaz is for Allah. You're not supposed to concentrate. When we were young, when we used to go to the mosque, our ustaz used to say, "You didn't read namaz properly." And the cheeky ones amongst us, they used to say, "How were you looking at us when you were reading your namaz?" So you see, when you read namaz, namaz is for Allah, and you should be concentrating. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reading namaz. Now, if somebody is on the same side, you can see from the corner of your eye, fine. But when somebody is behind you, how can you comment on his namaz? Because when a person is standing behind, he's silent. You can't see him, you can't hear him. True? So the Prophet ﷺ, after namaz, he says, "Ala tuhsin salatak." These words are in Bukhari and in Muslim. So the person said to the Prophet ﷺ, "Ya Rasulullah, how is it possible that you saw whether I read correctly or whether I read incorrectly? How is it possible?" And the Prophet ﷺ said, his hadith, "Wallahi la yakhfa alayya khushukum wa la ruku'ukum inni la araakum min Wallahi, you know when you want to say something when you really mean it, you say Wallahi, Khuda di kasme, you say Wallahi, I swear by Allah. Yani it means that there is no aura of doubt. Wallahi, La yakhfa. These are the words of Bukhari. La yakhfa. And the word yakhfa is fi'l muzari'ah. Muzari'ah means for present and future. La yakhfa alayya. Khushu'ukum wa la ruku'ukum. I swear by Allah that the piety in your heart and your ruku' is not hidden from me. The piety in your heart and your ruku'. Now where is the piety? Is that in your, where is your heart? Is that inside you or outside you?
Heart,
huh? Heart is inside. So the Prophet ﷺ says that your piety is not hidden from me. Your piety is not hidden from me. And ruku'ukum. Do you do ruku on the inside or on the outside? MashaAllah. I'm very happy to hear that. There was one Jahil who came to Coventry and he started to say that he was some peer of some kind, and he said, Naiji, namaz to dil mein hoti hai. Namaz you read in your heart. So many people who didn't read namaz, they said, Wah ji, kya baat hai. This peace up is the best peace up. Why? Because namaz dil mein, jaan tooti finished. So he said, no, I happened to pass by and they said, meet our great scholar and our great sheikh. I said, I don't want to meet him, but anyway, let me find out, is this true or not? He says, you had namaz is in your heart. I said, subhanallah, namaz is in your heart. He said, yes, if namaz is not in your heart, what is the use of this external namaz? So real namaz is in your heart. I said, namaz is in your heart. And then, what about purity? He said, yes, real purity is in your heart. So you can do wuzu from the outside, but you can remain impure inside. So namaz is in your heart, wuzu is in your heart. So I said, then maybe you should do istinja in your heart also. Said, what's the use of doing external istinja? Fine. Forget it. Why the hassle? But if everything is going to be in your heart, why do it elsewhere? So these formalities are meant istinja and wudu and all these namaz, these are intended not only for the batin, they are intended for the zahir. They are intended for the zahir. Anyway, so I explained that this is the case. So the Prophet ﷺ said that your internal and your external is not hidden from me. Your internal and your external. Khushu is in the internal and ruku is in the external. And the words of Muslim on this hadith, same hadith, is Wallahi la yakhfa alayya khushu'ukum wa la khuzu'ukum. Difference in words, but the meaning is the same. The words of the narration by Muslim is that Allah, I swear by Allah that your khushu and khuzu. What is the difference between khushu and khuzu?